Okay, we're up to the Gemara on Daf Lamed Tes Amud Beis. We're about twelve lines in the bottom. Omar Rav Yannai. So the Gemara says, Omar Rav Yannai. Rav Yannai said, Alias Goyrel Mitoich Kalpi Makevis. It's ma'akev that you have to, according to stick his hand in the box and take out a ballot to confirm which animal is which. But once he has it out of the box and he knows, let's say, that in his right hand he picked up the ballot that says Lashem, that's enough. Hanoch einu makev. He doesn't have to actually physically place the ballot down on top of the animal. You don't even have to lift the ballot up. In other words, the whole girl is not ma'akif. Let's see Rashi. Rashi says, Aliyah einim af aliyah einim makevis, v'm yikra ha-koin shem chatos ala achas, v'shem mazoz ala al-chaveirin. If the koin just declares that one's a chatos, so one's lazozel, Hukvu b'lay agrol, it would work without a goyel. She'ein agrol makevis. Ela shechis a mitzvah. So there's a mitzvah to do the goyel, but it's not going to be ma'akev. It'll still be a kosher korban. So that's the machloikis. The machloikis is if you didn't do the goyel at all, and you just declared one animal, or the kohen gadol declared one animal as Lashem and one as Lazazel, then the eved would be good. So Zok to Gemara, Alib Rav Yehuda, the Omar, Dvar Manasim Vigdi Lofen Bechutz Loi Ma'akvim, according to Rav Yehuda, who holds that any of the avoiders that are done, even though they're done with the Vigdi Lofen, but they're done out of the Kodesh HaKodeshim, not in the Kodesh HaKodeshim, Loi Ma'akvim, the order of those avoiders are not Ma'akvim, Kula Amal Loi Pligi Loi Ma'akvim. Everybody agrees, both Rabbi Yama and Rabbi Yochanan would both agree that Agrola is not done in the Kodesh HaKodeshim. So therefore, it's not Makav. Keep Ligi, their home machlokes between Rabbi Yama and Rabbi Yochanan is a Libra Rabbi Chem, who holds that all of it is a Makav. Now let's just get a closer look at this machlokes between Rabbi Yehuda and Rabbi Nechemia, because it's going to come into play. So let's see Rashi. A Libra Rabbi Yehuda, Perakot Tziu Loi, and Av Samach, Pligi Rabbi Yehuda Rabbi Nechemia, Im Shina Beseder Avodos. What if you went out of order, Lahak de Mesam Ocher, and you did an avoid that was supposed to be done later, you did it earlier. What would be that loch? V'am Rabbi Nechemia, Kol Seder Avodos, Shenasis Big Day Lavan. Any of the avoida that the Kohen Gadol is supposed to do with his Big Day Lavan, Bein bifnim, saif it's inside, meaning can go in lefnai v'lefnim, if it's done in the Kodesh HaKodeshim, like the zrikos of dam of some of the karbanis, haktoris haktoris, or bein b'chutz, or even if they're done in the heichal, going behechal, oy ba'azorah, or even completely out of the Beis HaMikdash, in the azorah itself, ma'akif, those, the order has to be precisely as listed in the Torah. The chukah, the word chukah, which indicates that it's ma'akev precisely as the Torah describes it, is referring to all those avodos that are done with the Bigdei Lavan. Rabbi Hudaimer likes a chukah, el bedvar menasim bebigdei lavan b'fnim. The chukah mentioned in the Torah is only referring to a subset of the avodos done in the Bigdei Lavan, and those are the avoidance that are done in the Kodesh HaKodeshim. Hilchah HaGrolah, the Goyrol, which isn't even done in the Hechel at all, it's done outside. She'en Inasis Mifnim Elim Yibchutz, the Rabbi Yehuda, the Amar Advarim Shanasim Yibchutz, L'Ksi B'chuka, according to Rabbi Yehuda, who holds that on things that are not in the Kodesh HaKodeshim, the Torah didn't say Chuka, to mean that it has to be precisely, the Kula Amal L'Pligid, Afilu Rabbi Yaleh Moedid, Rabbi Yehuda Le Ma'akva, the likes of Behu Kuva. It doesn't say any lashon of ikuv that's ma'akev b'di'evad, and by dvarim of kachim, generally speaking, unless the Torah says something specific, it's not ma'akev, like repeating it or saying chukah. So since chukah doesn't apply to the avoidus that are done out of the kodesh hakodeshim, they're not ma'akev. So that's what the Gemara wants to say. According to Rabbi Yehuda, everybody agrees it's not ma'akev. The whole question is, according to Rabbi Nechemya, that it is ma'akev. Aliba de Rabbi Nechemya, manda amr ma'akva, Rabbi Nechemya. The manda amr who holds that the avoda is ma'akev, which is Rabbi Yanai, you have to make the girl. That goes according to Rabbi Nechemya, who holds, since the girl was done while the Kohen Gadol was wearing big elofim, it's ma'akev. Manda maloy ma'akva, and Rabbi Yechim holds, you don't have to do the girl. Hanamili avoda, which items that did Rabbi Nechemya say are ma'akev in the big day lovin? Avoid is done in the big day lovin, but hagrol alav avoidi. So sure, it says chukah to include all avoidis to be ma'akev, but the goyel itself is not an avoida. It's sort of a prerequisite. It's a preparatory step where they're preparing the avoida, but it's not the avoida itself. Okay. Dr. Gemara Viter, Ikud Amri, there's another way to understand this machlokes. That Alibud Rav Nechemi, the Amar Ma'akva, according to Rav Nechemi, who holds that all of the avoidus are Ma'akiv, Kul Ma'akula Alma, Loi Pligi de Ma'akva. Everybody agrees that the girl is Ma'akiv. Keep Ligi Alibud Rav Yehuda. The whole machlokes is only according to Rav Yehuda. If you hold that it's not ma'akev, like Rabbi Yochanan says, he'll hold like Rabbi Yehuda, that any avodah that's not done in the Kodesh HaKodeshim is not ma'akev. And the mandamer who holds that it's ma'akev, why over here is it ma'akev, if according to Rabbi Yehuda, no avodahs are ma'akev other than those in the Kodesh HaKodeshim, Shani Hacha, the Tana Beikra. The Torah repeats the inyan of the girl twice. And when the Torah repeats things by kachim, that means to say that it's ma'akev. And where does the Torah repeat itself? It says Asher Allah and Asher Allah. It says twice Asher Allah, love a girl. And since it says Trezimne, even Rabbi Yehuda would agree that although all the avodas aren't ma'akev, the girl itself is ma'akev. So that's our machlokes. Once again, the base machlokes was that Rabbi Yame held that the girl is ma'akev, and Rabbi Yechon holds the girl is not ma'akev. And the question is how it fits in with an earlier machlokes tanoim between Rabbi Yehuda and Rabbi Nechemya. In the first nusach, we had that according to Rabbi Nechemya, according to Rabbi Yehuda, everybody would agree that it's not ma'akev, because it's an avodah shebechutz. And according to Rabbi Nechemya, there's no machlokes, where Rabbi Yana held it's ma'akev, and Rabbi Yochanan holds that a goyel is different. A goyel is not an avodah. The other nusach was that according to Rabbi Nechemya, everybody agrees it is ma'akev. And the question is, maybe even according to Rabbi Yehuda it's ma'akev, because it says, Asher Allah love a girl, it says it twice to say that the girl is more chomer than a regular avodah, and it is ma'akev. Meisvei freik the Gemara. Mitzvah lahagrel. There's a mitzvah. I just want to make sure that my sound is good. Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, good.
Yeah.
Meisvei freik the Gemara. Mitzvah lahagrel. There's a mitzvah to do the girl. V'mloi higrel kasher. So this brisa is saying quite clearly that the girl is not ma'akev, the mleihigul kosher. So let's figure this out. Bishlama lahach lishna, the amrit alibidir Rabbi Yehuda, kul amalai pligi, the loy ma'akev, bishlama according to the first lashon that we had, that according to Rabbi Yehuda, everybody would agree that the girl is not ma'akev. And the whole machloikus is according to Rabbi Nechemya. So Hamani, you can argue that this brisa that says as a blanket statement, the girl is not ma'akev, Rabbi Yehuda goes according to Rabbi Yehuda, and therefore both Rabbi Yochanan and both Rabbi Yanai agree that according to Rabbi Yehuda, the girl is not ma'akev. So that's perfect. Ella, if you're going to learn lahachlishna, but if you're going to learn like the second lashon, the amud pligi, so let's think about it. According to the second lashon, according to Rabbi Nechemiah, everybody agrees the goril is makiv. According to Rabbi Yehuda, it's a machloikis. According to Rabbi Yechon, it's not makiv. According to Rabbi Yana, it is makiv. So kum tochlois, according to Rabbi Yana, there is no tana at all that holds that the goril is not makiv. According to Rabbi Nechemiah, it's makiv. Everybody agrees. And even according to Rabbi Yehuda, he wants to say it's makiv because it says it's harala twice. So if you hold alhach lishad amrit pligi, they're arguing even in Rabbi Yehuda, Bishlam leman darma loy ma'akve, Bishlam according to Rabbi Yochanan, who holds that in according to Rabbi Yehuda, the girl is not ma'akiv, hamani Rabbi Yehudi. You could say the brass is going according to Rabbi Yehuda, and therefore it's not ma'akiv. And leman darma ma'akve, according to Rabbi Yanai, who holds that even according to Rabbi Yehuda, the girl is ma'akiv, early according to Rabbi Nechemiah it's ma'akiv, well then hamani. This brisa that says the girl is not makif, which tana is it going to be going according to? It can't be going according to Rabbi Nechemiah, because according to Rabbi Nechemiah, it's surely makif, and even according to Rabbi Yehuda, it's makif. So where are we going to find the tana who holds that the girl is not makif? Zok the Gemara, tani mitzvah laniach. Change the brisa. Don't say it's a mitzvah lahagril, the mlohigal kosher. Say it's a mitzvah after you lifted up the girl. There's a mitzvah to put it down on the animal. If you didn't put it down on the animal, you yotze. So we're changing it, and we're saying instead of the brisa referring to the girl, it's referring to the anachos. So someone's asking, if you don't make a girl, how do you know which goes where? How do you know which is the lasos and which is the lashem? So Rashi said earlier that the kohen can arbitrarily pick whichever one he wants. So Zok to Gemara, Tashma, Mitzvah Lahagra. It says, Azoy, there's a mitzvah to make a girl, Ul Hisvadois, and to say Vidui, and the Vidui we know is said on the Seira Mishtalech. What happens if Loi Higra, Loi Hisvadu? What if one did not do the girl, and one did not do Vidui? Kosher, it will still be kosher. So we see clearly that if you didn't do the girl, it's kosher. So it repeats the kasha that we said before. If you hold that even according to Rabbi Yehuda, you need a girl, who is this brisa going to be going with? And if you want to infer this last brisa, the same way we answer the Friedrich brisa, by arguing that when it says Hagril, it doesn't really mean Gairil, means to put it down, which means everybody would agree that you have to make the Gairil, and the Shaila here is only if you actually have to place the Gairil back down on the Behemoth. Emo Seifo. The Seifo of this last Brisa that we quoted is going to cause a problem if you're going to learn that the discussion of the Brisa is not about the Gairil itself, but just about putting the ballot down on top of the animal after you made the Gairil. Because the Sefer says, Reb Shimon argues on this price, and Reb Shimon says, Loi Higril kosher, Loi Yisvade possible. Reb Shimon said, Loi Higril will be kosher, Loi Yisvade will be possible. So he seems to be arguing by Vidu only on the Tanakhama. So let's think a second. My Loi Higril, when Reb Shimon said Loi Higril kosher, what did Reb Shimon mean? Ilem and Loi Hiniach. If you want to learn that all it means is lo hiniach, because that's the shaila, because we want an answer to this brisa when it says higrel, does it really mean girl? Because for sure you need the girl. The shaila is only if you have to place the girl on the animal after you lifted it out of the box. So if you're going to say that's what it means, well, that means mechalal Reb Shimon Sover hagrala ma'akva. If Reb Shimon says lo hiniach kosher lo yisvad apostle, that means he's saying dafka lo hiniach is kosher. But if you didn't make the girl at all, Reb Shimon would agree that it's possible. That's a problem. So ilayim lo hiniach, if you're saying that it's only speaking about hiniach, but the girl for sure must be done, mechlal de Reb Shimon sover hagrol ma'akva, I'll prove to you that Reb Shimon holds that the girl is not ma'akva. But Tanya, so now we've just discovered a new Tana besides Rabbi Nechemiah and Rabbi Yehuda, who argue about all avoidus in the Big Day Lovam, we have a Tanner Rabbi Shimon who discusses specifically Goyrel, who's going to say that the Goyrel is not Makkah. But Tanya, Meis Echad Mehen, Mevi Chaveri Shaloi Bagroa. There was a discussion, and they were interesting case. You made the Goyrel, you established, you determined that one animal is Lashem, and one animal is Lazazel. And then, one of these two animals die. So, what do? So Rav Shimon holds, you just take another animal to replace the animal that dies. The problem is, that new animal didn't have a Goyrel. And Rav Shimon holds, that if Meis Echad Mehen, Mevi Chaver Shaloi Bagroa, Divrei Rav Shimon. So you see clearly that Rav Shimon holds you don't need the Goyrel. So we need to stop for a second. We had the first kasha. The Gemara asked the kasha from their first brach on the bottom of Amud Beis that if it was loy higril, it will be kosher. And the Gemara had a problem because it didn't fit in like a Nechemi, it didn't fit in like a Yehuda. So Tosfos asks, we now have a shita we've just discovered, the shita of Rav Shimon, who says that you don't need the Goyrel, the Goyrel is not ma'akiv. So why did the Gemara struggle up here? The Gemara should have just said that Braisa that says that the Goyrel is not Ma'akiv, is not Rabbi Yehuda, it's not Rabbi Nechemiah, but it's Rabbi Shimon. So that's the kasha that Tosfos asks. So Tosfos answers that we have a secondary raya that Braisa cannot be going according to Rabbi Shimon, because the Seifa that Braisa also quotes Rabbi Shimon, which would indicate that the Reish of the Braisa would not be Rabbi Shimon. But I'll call upon them over here. We've just proven that Rav Shimon holds that the Goyrel is not Ma'akiv. And the way we want to learn the Braisa, that Loi Higrel means Loi Yiniach, that would indicate that Rav Shimon holds that the Goyrel is Ma'akiv. So that poses a problem for us. So Dr. Gemara, the way you're going to have to learn the Braisa is in a more complicated way. And you're going to have to say Rav Shimon Lo Yoda, my Kami Rabbanim. So let's go back to the Braisa. The Braisa said Mitzvah Lahagril, Ule Svadois, Lohigo v'loy svada kosher. The Tanakhama says lohigo v'loy svada kosher. And what we wanted to say, that what the Tanakhama means is lohigo means lohiniach. But avada, if he didn't make the girl, it wouldn't be kosher. And then comes along Rav Shimon and says lohigo kosher. Now we know that Rav Shimon must mean lohigo, not lohiniach, because we just proved that Rav Shimon holds lohigo is kosher. So the question is there's a little bit of disconnect, because the Tanakhama seems to be saying lohiniach is kosher, and Rav Shimon is responding that lahigrel is kosher. So the Gemara says there's a little bit of a miscommunication between Rav Shimon and the Chachamim. Rav Shimon lo yodem mai kamei rabban, v'hachik amarlo, and this is what Rav Shimon meant to tell the Chachamim. Iagrel hagrel amamish. If when you said earlier lohigrel kosher, you meant that you don't even have to make a girl, that's what you actually meant, kamrisu, if that's what you said, then polgincha poligna alaihu bechada. Because if you said la higrel is really kosher, I agree with that. But when you said la yisvad apostle, that's where I'm disagreeing with you, because I hold even if you didn't say vidui on the sira mishtaleach, it would still be a kosher garment. But iagrola de kamrisu, hainu hanacha, if when you said la higrel, you meant that avada you're mechuyev to make the girl, you're just not mechuyev to put it on the animal. Well, if that's what you meant, then paligna alaychu betarti, then I dispute both of your halachas. A, I hold that the goyrel is not ma'akib, and B, I hold vidui is not ma'akib. So once again, we don't have a right. Zog to Gemara, toshma. Par ma'akib es ha-sayir, u-sayir ein ma'akib es ha-par, b'matana shebifnim. The par will be ma'akev the se'ir, and the se'ir will not be ma'akev the par. What does this mean? So Rashi tells us that it's a question of order. So let's see Rashi. Par ma'akev is a se'ir. Im hikdim achas min ha'avoyde shal se'ir ha'me'uchore shal par. So there was a voidus that was done with the blood of the par. It was spritzed lefnai v'lefnim. It was spritzed on the paroiches. It was spritzed on the mizbech ha'zohav. And there were also zrikas of dam that was done with the Sira Mishtaleach. And there was an order to them. And Rashi is going to tell us right over here exactly how the order was done. And Rashi tells us that if im hiktim achas min avodos shel seir ham ucharis, if you did one of the avodos on the seir that was supposed to be later lishal par, it was supposed to be after an avoda that was done for the par, but instead also koydim lepar, and instead you did the avoda, you did some type of zrika of the seir before you're supposed to, then hapar shehu royu likadim lo, the par that was supposed to be before the seir, me'akva, it will be me'akiv the avoda upsula upaisla, and the avoda will be possible ve'ena oiloi, and it doesn't work. And you're going to be forced to repeat that avoda again. The Bach changes the order of the Rashi. Because the Bach, before it goes into the Seder Avoda, it quotes the other side of the halacha, that Avla Seir ain't a makav zapar. But if you did the par, if you did a zarika on the par before an avoid of the seer in an area where the seer is supposed to be first, and make them avoid the par, but who we name who chorus the shal seer, vassal of nice seer, ain't a seer, shall we roy the kadim la poisla. So if you did an avoid on the seer before an avoid on the par out of order, then the avoid of the seer will have to be done again. But on the flip side, if you did the avoid on the par earlier than you're supposed to, you won't have to do it again. What is the proper avoda? So let's go back to the last thin line of Rashi. This is an important Rashi because it actually tells us step by step how the avodas are done. The Seder Avodah is saying kachi b'parsha. B'tchilah misvad ala par vidur rishon. First, you make vidur on the par vidur rishon, which we already learned the Mishnah about. V'yachach magril ala seir. Then he goes over to the east side of the Azara and he makes the goyal on the seir, which we also learned in our Mishnah. I don't think we learned that in the Mishnah yet. After he does the girl for the seer, then he goes back to the par and he says a second set of vidui. Then v'shachte. Then you shech the par. Then umachnis kafu machta v'noisin zaktar shalayish. Then the Kohen Gadol brings the ketores into the Kodesh HaKodesh. After that, v'noisin midam apar al akapores. Then he spritzes from the blood of the par that he shechted earlier onto the kaparis. The aragach shoicher es haseir. Then he goes to shecht the seir lashem, and then v'noisim mimendu ala kaparis. And then he brings dam from the seir mishaleich. Sorry, from the seir lashem onto the kaparis. The aragach noisim midam apor al parochus. Then he goes back to the dam apor and he spritzes some of it on the parochus. The aragach midam haseir. Then he goes back and takes a dam seir and spritzes it on the parochus. The arech ma'ar of dam, and then he mixes the blood of the par with the blood of the seir. V'noisnal mizbech apnimi, and he puts it on the mizbech apnimi. Now you know why the Kohen Gadol had to practice for 7 days, because this was very confusing, going back and forth and back and forth. There are some avodas of the par that precede the avodah of the seir. There's some avodas of the seir that precede the avodah of the par. So let's see what the Brashah tells us. Right, tells us par ma'akev is a seir. If you did an avoda on the seir prematurely before a scheduled avoda that should have been done with the par, then it will be ma'akev. But seir ain't ma'akev is a par. But if you did the avoda the par early, that will not be ma'akev. Be matanah shebefnim, we're referring to the zrikas dam that are inside the Beis Hamikdash. Bishlam a par ma'akev is a seir. I can understand practically how that would occur, that if you spritz the blood of the Seir too early, if you did an avoda of the Seir too early, it's out of order, and therefore the avoda won't work. And what would be the case? The Akdami L'Seir, Mikami Par, L'Ovid V'Leklum. If you did one of the Zrikas of the Seir before you did the Par, before you did the avoda that was required to be done earlier on the Par, you'd have to do it again. However, El Seir Ein Ma'akibus Apar. But the other case that the Brashi discusses, that if for some reason you did on the voida, on the par, before you were supposed to, before an avoida that was scheduled to on this year, my neil, what exactly would be the case? So let's review what the order is supposed to be back in Rashi, and let's look at the possibilities. Okay, b'tchila misvad ala par, vidur rishon, that's supposed to go first. V'yachach magril ala seir. V'yachach misvad ala par. vidusheni. So the first thing that you might discuss is if you did the second vidui on the par before the goral. But that's not relevant because we're talking about avodah shebefnim. We're talking about an avodah that was done in the heichal. So then it goes back into the shachta yishech the par. Machlis kafu machlim noisim sekteris. But noisim idam par like a paris. The achach shoicher as a seir. The noisim imen al kaparis. The achach noisim idam par la paroich. So maybe this dam par that you did on the paroiches, maybe you did it before you put the blood of the seir on the kaparis. That might be what it's referring to. So the Gemara says, mind you, ilemi di aktim matanis to par behecho, the kama matanis to seir befnim, which is exactly this case, the dam that you spritzed from the par in the hecho on the paroiches, you did it before you spritzed the dam of the seir on the kaparis itself. That's the only case we can easily find where it would be out of order. Frek the Gemara chukik said behu. You can't argue that that's what the brisa means, that it wouldn't be ma'akiv, because it says chukah regarding those avoidus, and they have to be done exactly as said. So you can't argue that if that was done out of order, it would be kosher. El alav, the only other option there is to find a case where if you did the par before the seir, it would be out of order, is the akten matanis the par bifnim mekame hagrola. The only other option is that you spritz the blood of the par inside the Kodesh HaKodeshim before you did the girl, because that's the only other thing that could have been out of order. Zok to Gemara, since this Bryce has said that if it was done out of order, it's not going to be a problem. If the order is not ma'akiv, it must be by definition that Ikir HaGrol Anami Loi Ma'akiv. Because if the Avoida was ma'akiv and it's a real and true Avoida, well then surely it should be ma'akiv. It must be. The reason why the Braisa says that it's not ma'akiv is only because it's not a real avoida. And therefore, even if it was done after an avoida that it should have done before, so if you did something from the par before the girl, when you're supposed to do something from the par after the girl, it's not a problem because the girl's not ma'akiv anyway. So you have a raya that the girl's not ma'akiv, which is a raya, once again, to Rabbi Yochanan. Zoktimur loy. That's not what this means. What it means is the akten matnois to par b'mizbeach mekame matnois to seir b'hechol. What it could mean is later on it says that you had to mix, v'achach midam asir, v'achach ma'arv dom v'nois tol mizbeach apnimi. Maybe you put the blood from the par on the mizbeach apnimi before you spritz the dam of the seir. Maybe that's what it's referring to. Rabbi Yehudi, and it could be following the sheet of Rabbi Yehuda, the Amar Dvar Manasim B'Ludeg De'Lovam B'Chutz Loi Ma'akvi. And it could be going according to Rabbi Yehuda, who taught us earlier that things that are done with the Big De'Lovam, if they're not done in the Kodesh HaKodeshim, they're just done in the Kodesh, like on the Mizbech HaPnimi, there they won't be, the order is not Ma'akvi. Frek to Gemara, how could you say that we're speaking about matanos that are out of the Kodesh HaKodeshim, that they're bechutz, and therefore you could argue that Rabbi Yehuda holds that avoidus that are done out of the Kodesh HaKodeshim don't have to be in order? That's not the words of the Braisa. But matanos shebefnim katani. If we go back to the beginning of the Braisa, it says par makav is a seir, b'seir makav is a par, b'matanos shebefnim. So befnim would mean inside the Kodesh HaKodeshim, where even Rabbi Yehuda agrees it has to be in order. Zokta Gemara, you're right. So we have to abort that suggestion to explain the Braisa. We'll have to say, Allahamani Rab Shimini, we're going to have to say that the Braisa that says that if the par was done before if an avoid of the par was done before avoid of the seir, it's talking about the girl. It's going according to Rab Shimini, Domar Agrola Loi Ma'akva. It's going to have to be going according to Rab Shimini, holds the girl is not ma'akib. And therefore, even if you did one of the Zrikas, out of order, even if you didn't want to drink it out of order, it will not be a problem. Zog to Gemara, v'boyesema, or you can argue la'olam Rabbi Yehuda, or you can say it is going according to Rabbi Yehuda. Unhida besidra, lo'y ma'akva, hagrola mi'a ma'akva. Even though you're not makbar on the order, even according to Rabbi Yehuda, you're not makbar on the order, you could still say that you're, there's a chiyuv to make the girl, and you still have to make the girl. Okay, so this takes us to a whole new sugi va'azu l'tamai. So let's just see Rashi. Ma'akva hagrola. Dehala Rabbi Yehuda loksiva chuka advara manasim b'chutz. Even though that according to Rabbi Yehuda, it doesn't say chuka regarding avodas that are done outside. So agrola is done b'chutz. It shouldn't be ma'akiv. But agrola mia ki akir le'legamrei ma'akiv. So Rabbi Yehuda holds the girl might not have to be done in a specific order. But even if it doesn't have to be done in a specific order, it has to be done. The Tana Beikra, because the Torah said Asher Allah twice. Now, V'ozu Tamayu, Zot Rashi, which Tosfos argues on, is going back on the Machloikis earlier. So according to Rashi, it's a little bit out of order, because we had a whole different Toshma. But before this Toshma, we discussed the Machloikis between Rav Shimon and the Chachamim, whether or not Vidui is Ma'akiv. So the Braisa said, Mitzvah lahagrul u'sfadish, lahigav lo yisfadah kosher, and Rav Shimon said, lo yisfadah posel. So Zot the Gemara, the Azul Tamayu, this machloikis that we quoted earlier, whether or not saying vidui on the Sira Mishtaleach, if it's ma'akiv the carbon, is totally in a different machloikis. The Tanya we learned, Yomat Chai. It says in the Pasuk that the Sira Mishtaleach should be Yomat Chai, Lefnei Hashem, Lechaper Olaf. So the Gemara wants to know, Ad Mosai Yezok Lamrit Chai. Up until what point does the Seir Mishtaleach have to remain alive? In other words, what if the Seir Mishtaleach died before you had a chance to push it down the mountain? Would it be possible? Or would it be kosher? So, Ad Mosai Yezokuk Lamoit Chai. Until what point does the Seir Mishtaleach have to remain alive? Zokti Gemar, Ad Shas Matan Domai Shal Chaveri. Until after they spritz the blood of the Seir Lashem, Divi Rabbi Yehuda. Rabbi Shimon Eimer, much earlier, at Shas Vidui, Dvarim. The Seir Mishtalech only has to remain alive until Vidui is stated. Zok Rashi Yomat Chai. Al Korach L'Lamdeinu, when it says in the Pasuk that the Seir Mishtalech has to remain alive, it's teaching us, She'emeis at a Tzorich L'Havi Acher. If the Seir Mishtalech died too early, you're going to have to bring another Seir Mishtaleach. The Eloi, because if that's not what the Torah is trying to teach us, when it says Yom HaTchai, Lamai also, what is the Yom HaTchai coming to teach us? Im Toimar, if the Torah is just trying to teach us, Shaloi Yishalchenu, Ad L'Acher Matan Domim, if it's just trying to tell you that you shouldn't actually push it off the mountain until after the Zrikas Adam, well then it should say, Yom HaTchai Lefnei Hashem. It's a yomad lefnei Hashem. It should wait there lefnei Hashem lechaper olav until the zrikas adam is accomplished. But why does a chai yomad chai? The extra word chai lomeli. It must be coming to tell you elisha emes tzarich lehavi acher. The pasuk is telling us that if the seir mishtaleach dies before you push it down the mountain, you have to bring another one. So the shaili is, how long does it have to survive? Does it have to survive until the dam from the seir lashem is spritzed? Or does it have to survive only until the vidui? But my kamiflagi, what is the machloikis? Kidetanya, lechaper, it says lechaper. Yom etchai lefnei Hashem lechaper olav. What does it mean lechaper? The kapar is dami makos medaber. It's referring to the kapar that's affected when the zrika of the dam of the seir l'Hashem is performed. The chenu aimer, the chila mechaper es hakodesh. And malalah bekaparis damim, just like by that pasuk, it's referring to zrika. Afkan the kaparis damim divir Rabbi Yehuda. So the pasuk is telling us, Yom etchai lefnei Hashem lechaper olav, the seir lazozel must remain alive until the dam of the seir l'Hashem was spritzed. Rabbi Shimon Eimer lechaper olav bekaparis dvarim akosef bedaber. When it says lechaper olav, it means until you say vidui on it. Once you say vidui on it, and you have your kapara, then it doesn't matter if it dies anymore. So this machloikis that we had on the Amud Aleph, whether or not vidui's ma'akiv, would be totally in the machloikis how long the seir mishtaleach has to be alive. If it has to be alive until the vidui, because the vidui affects the kapara, then you would hold that the vidui's ma'akiv like the chacham. And if you hold that the Avida is not Ma'akev, then you would hold that it's totally in the dam. So let's see what Rashi says. Could the parish time will come on, like we're going to explain short. So Zok to Gemara. Tashma. Sha'alu Talmidav es Rabbi Akiva. Now we're going back to our previous machloikis as to whether or not you have to make the Gemara. Sha'alu Talmidav es Rabbi Akiva. They asked Rabbi Akiva the following shayla. What would happen if Olah b'Shmuel? Everyone knows that the Kohen Gadol always hoped to pick up the ballot that says Lashem in his right hand. Well, what if this year wasn't such a good year and he picked up the ballot that said Lashem in his left hand? Ma'u shiach shel yamin. Could he just pass it to his right hand? Amar lahen. So Rabbi Akiva told the Talmidim, don't consider such an option. It might be kosher. It might work. But don't do it for a different reason. Al titnu makam l'tzedoikim. And it's really the center. Really, it's supposed to say laminim. Al titnu makam laminim. Meaning to the Christians. Because a min is Rosh HaTevis mitalmidav shal yeshoi hanoitri. So al titnu makam l'tzedoikim. Don't give them an opening liridois to fight with you and to argue and to show that your halacha is not really true, and it's all false, and you can play with it. Let's see what Rashi says. Tidnu makom l'tzedakim talmidim. And once again, this should say minim hacholkim al haTorah. Don't give them a place to argue, where they're always looking to find an inconsistency in the Torah. Lirdois to become forceful, a limshal behen, and to rule over you. It's supposed to behen. On you, don't give them an opportunity to have problems with Torah, like a peich has from bedvarim, to attack you with words. To say that the Torah is all a fake, you're doing whatever you want. And by doing that, it would lead them to say something like that. And we learn from
you. You know, Yossi, we don't often hear something like that, and I'm wondering why bedafkan this particular halacha, there's so many other places they can make this argument. Because we use so many drushes and so many, you know, to figure out what the halacha is, and some of them are very tenuous. So why bedafka here? Suddenly here we're worried about the minim?
Well, because here, if the kohen doing the avoda, he picks it up in his right hand, and in front of everybody, he slides it into his left hand, so everyone sees that this whole thing is arbitrary. So it's not so much focusing on the psak. It's focusing on, if you let someone do an action like that in public, it shows that even he doesn't take the Torah seriously. So they'll be able to point, hey, look, everybody, this whole thing's a fake.
So many things until now were arbitrary. You know, is it ma'akev? Isn't ma'akev? You know, it seems... When the Torah says explicitly, you have to do a geirah. Now we find out, it's not ma'akev. So it's not necessary to do a geirah. That's also the same problem.
In the Chadami, but I don't think the Gemara is focusing on the academic portion. The Gemara is focusing on when there's going to be a public spectacle occurring, that he's going to lift it up with his left hand, and he's going to pass it off to his right hand. That creates a public spectacle, which would be a mockery of the geirah. In the academic circles, and I don't know if they're worried about the academic circles. I think they're worried about in the public spectrum, when he's doing the avoda, people will see that he's doing that. But Lamaisa, you were right what you're saying, because the Gemara, the Achronim bring a rye from this Gemara. There was a case, somebody was asking a Shaila, I think someone asked Shlomo Zalman Orbach, if you're allowed to use gelatin. Now, the halacha is, mikra din, gelatin that you take from even treifa animals is kosher. It's not impacted by the iser of behemoth tmeo. I know Rav Shimon Eiders et al. Had a kosher gelatin company, but one of the poskim felt that it would be not proper to be matter kosher gelatin, even though technically it's kosher, because of this reason. Because it allows people to potentially make a mockery out of halacha. So you're right. There's a lot of things that we don't understand exactly why Rabbi Akiva applied his hesitation to this specifically. I agree with you. It could be this was a public spectacle, but I don't know. But the Gemara is being medayik from here. Taima, the altit nemakam l'tzadoikim l'artos. The whole problem that Rabbi Kiva had is that when people see it, they can make fun. But besides that, me'ikar adin, he wouldn't have had a problem. Halav hachi madrinin le. So if it wasn't for that, Rabbi Kiva would have said, yeah, you could just swap it around. But ve'amr tagrela ma'akva. But you just said, you, Rabbi Yannai, says that the girl is ma'akev. And if the girl is ma'akev, which means the girl is what determines which is the Lashem and which is the Lazazel. The Kivin de Kavata smile, since we've already established that the animal on the left is the animal that's the Lashem, Heichem Adrinale. You can't arbitrarily switch that over. The girl does the effect. Amarava Hachik Amri. This is what the Talmidim meant to ask. Allah Goyal Bismile, if you lifted up the girl in your left hand, not that you should just put it on the right animal and change, you can't do that. The question is, Mao Sheyachziru Loy Ulasira Lemin. Could they now take the animal that I was on the left side, move the animal to the right side, and try to retroactively make it look like it was the one on the right side? On that he said, Amalem, that which technically would be good, because the animal that was supposed to be designated Lashem will still be designated Lashem, but don't do that. Al titnu makom l'tzadukim l'radois, because once again, it looks like you're swapping away from the goyel, and that will make a mockery out of the law. Toshma, ilu namar, if it would have only said es haseir asher olav, it doesn't say that. It says in the pasuk es haseir asher olav hagoyel. If it wouldn't have said Allah, if it would have just said Asir Asher Olav HaGoyel, Hayisi Omer Yanuchenu Olav, I would have thought that you have to put the Goyel on the animal. Because we just discussed several times that the Hanocha is not Ma'akiv. Once you lifted the Goyel up and you established which one is Lashem, which one is Lazazel, L'chadchili is supposed to place the Goyel on the animal. But it's not Ma'akiv. If you didn't place the Goyel on the animal, it would still work. Talmud Lamer Allah, the Pasuk tells you Allah, Kivin Sha'Allah Shuv Einitzar. Once you lifted the girl up and determined which animal is which, you don't have to do any more than that. You don't have to place it down on the animal. Lamai, Lagabi, what halacha is this Brisa telling us that you don't have to put it down? Ilema la mitzvah, if you're going to tell me that there's not even a mitzvah l'chatchila to place the girl on the animal, we know that's not true. No one's going to say that it's not a mitzvah l'chatchila to put the goyel on the animal. It just means that if you didn't place it on the animal, it's not ma'akiv. So from this price, you clearly see hagrola ma'akva, lifting it up and identifying which animal is which, that is ma'akiv. But anochaloi ma'akva. So once again, this is going to be a kash on Rabbi Yannai, it's a kash on Rabbi Yochanan, who says the girl is not ma'akiv, and the kohen can pick anyone he wants. This is not how you should read the brisa. Rather, read it as follows. Ilu nemar asher olav. If it just said asher olav, but it didn't say asher olav, then ha'yisi oimer yanichenu olav at shashchita. Then I would have thought that's not enough to leave the ballot on the animal for a little while. You have to leave it on the animal the entire time until it's actually shechted. Talmud loimer asher olav, which is Kivin Sha'Allah Shuvin Itzar. Once you put it on the animal for even a little bit, that will be good enough. But Avada, the Goro will not necessarily be Ma'akav. Tashma, Vaso Chatos. It says that the Goro that was Lashem, you make that carbon, that animal that had Lashem, you make it into a carbon Chatos. And we darshan, HaGoro Loiseu Chatos. The Goro makes it into a Chatos. Vein Hashem Loiseu Chatos. Merely the kohen declaring that this animal is Lashem, that doesn't work. It has to be done through the girl. Sheyochol, because you would have thought otherwise. Well, I didn't know. You can make a kavah chaymer. Umah b'makom shel kiddush ha-girl. Though the halacha is, whenever a person has to bring a carbon, like the two birds, once for a chatos and once for an oilo, like by the carbon oilo v'yoyrid, we're going to soon learn that they you, one of the birds has to be designated as the oila, and one of the birds has to be designated as the chatos. Now, how is it designated? It's designated when you say this is the oila, this is the chatos. If you made a girl between the two birds, which should be which, that wouldn't accomplish anything. So ma b'makom shalai kiddush ha-goyrel, kiddush Hashem, madach, when you have to identify which bird is an oila, which is a chatos, it doesn't work through a goyrel, but it does work through a declaration. Makom shekiddush ha-goyrel, in our case, but a se'ir mishtalayach, and the se'ir l'Hashem, where the goyrel does give it kiddusha, ein oidin she'ikadosh Hashem, shouldn't it also work just by declaration as well? And therefore, Talmud Leimer v'aso chatos, it teaches that a girl is a chatos, then Hashem is a chatos. So you have a brisa that's very explicitly stating that you need the girl. The girl is makif. Zok to Gemara, who is this brisa going according to? Stam Sifra, a normal brisa, Lagabi Karbonis, on Vayikra, Mani Rabbi Yehuda. That's normally Rabbi Yehuda. The Katani in Rabbi Yehuda, ha girl is a chatos, then Hashem is a chatos. So you see, Alma, even according to Rabbi Yehuda, Hagrala Makva, even according to Rabbi Yehuda, the girl will be Makav, which means Tiyufta, the man, the Omer, Hagrala Makva, Tiyufta. Rabbi Yochanan and Shita, that we had, that we started the day with, on Daf Lama Tesam Abbas, who said that the girl is not Makav, according to Rabbi Yehuda, he's Ogishlag, because clearly you see, even in Rabbi Yehuda, the girl is Makav. So this whole shaila we learned between Rabbi Yana and Rabbi Yochanan, if the girl is makiv, here the Gemara declares that avada the girl is makiv according to everybody. The only person that the girl is not makiv according to is Rabbi Shimon, because of his special shita that he held that the girl was not makiv. So I guess we can stop here. I want to thank once again ID Tech Solutions in Lakewood for letting me use their boardroom to say share in the morning.